Okay, I just want to take a shot of this is the entrance. Wow, look at that. Amazing. This is a piece. Called the Paperwings, shown at Bowling Green State University's Art Gallery. Enamel pieces. Room. This is from the up above. This is called the Tin Twin. Very early work. These are from iron. Little enamel pieces. Cows under a pepper tree. Drawing. That were like individually drawn every morning. It's like a morning wake up. Early piece called Fuka. It's all that's left of it. More drawings of pieces. Wayang puppets that the artist was in Indonesia for a number of years. And then she ended up making this piece here out of carved water buffalo hide from the carvers in Java that helped her to carve the pieces where she therefore painted or called sunging. Sewn parts on a sewing machine here. A little teacup. Moon puppets. See all the details here. Mm-hmm. You can see the little masks in the costume. There's a detail of an enamel section. Last night in the workshop, very similar techniques, secret masks made out of urushi. Studies for the larger pieces. You can see this mask reappear in Sleeping in a Sandstorm. These are just different casts from the masks. An early rendering, passage into a paper sea. All made out of handmade paper, where all little pieces were cast from paper, paper pulp, all up in here. All this is paper pulp. Little monkeys. Textile technique. There she is. The song made with Japanese urushi. You hardly see that just because of the lighting, but this is all plasma cut pieces. And then Japanese urushi, lacquer. Dishes of snow. The stick has lacquer on it. Urushi. There's a section of electroformed work because there's a lot of parallels with the color from the enamel that's also present in urushi. Enamel work. Love to make peak boxes as a child of the little drawings. These are like peak boxes that you could cut up drawings. This piece is made out of enamel and thread and little enamel heads. Another drawing that you could then peek through with a magnifying lens. More drawings here. This is also made with urushi, Japanese lacquer, with the textures on the arms. Kind of fun. It's a kind of like a chandelier of masks made from ceramic. And iron. It's a lifetime of work. In folds of gold. Also made with urushi, Japanese lacquer. There's a little face inside there. This is Henry. He was down on a little bicycle. All these, this little bicycle. Again, little puppets right there that were animated during the show. All of these masks, all of these feet were painted. Trying to use a traditional Japanese technique with the flowers and the roses of the landscapes they use in makie and Japanese urushi, and a tent. Some of the headdresses had beans wrapped up into it. Mother of pearl on the hands. Folded under a stone sleeping is the backside. Done with tulle and stitching on the sewing machine with gold thread. The little guy inside the head here. Here's the front of the mask. She was inspired. This is also done with sort of clay and urushi, the Japanese lacquer, and the little head on top of the sculpture. Also an urushi piece. With electroform lace. You can see the patterns of the urushi. The little balls that you would, little balls that are running through the whole costume. No, this is a sculpture. It was never performed. This one. Spider and the Buddha. There's her little face, the Buddha, made with tulle, with a little head on the inside, little puppet. Some props. This is the wooden sun, hard to see as a silhouette. The glass jungle. This is a chandelier of multiple masks. This is another Arushi piece. This is also an Arushi. These are all made with Arushi. Made with copper, all made out of copper. And that is the end of the exhibit. And we're back to this Paperwings piece where we enter in at the beginning. Thank you. You ready to go? We're ready. I'm ready. I've got my. I'm coming with you. Is this how we go?
No. I'm south.